just don't want to think, right? You don't want to think, right? It's just too much hard work about what do I wear. You just want to put something on and go. Hi guys, welcome back. This video I thought should be about just the things that I have been like reaching for the most these past few couple of weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. You know how you have a wardrobe of all your stuff, but there's always that few things that you always gravitate to. So these are my go-to pieces at the moment. All right, so first is what I am wearing. It is this jumper. It's a polo neck that I got from Forever 21. Yes, Forever 21. I have a thing for polo necks. I'm always looking for one that has like a fairly high neck, you know, like up there, and is quite like skinny on the body and the arms, because to me, they are the perfect layering pieces. So layering under dresses and tops, they're just a good base for me. So I always want it to feel relatively skinny to the body, but be high here. So I'm quite particular on the ones that I look for. And I was so surprised when I came across this one. It's a little bit sheer, which I didn't actually realize until I literally just sort of bought it. In person, it's not as sheer as it's coming across on the camera, but I think this is fantastic for the price. You can't beat it. I got it in 3 colors. I have it in gray, I have it in mustard, and I have it in this black. I love the idea of polo necks layered. I think that's absolutely fantastic. Whether it's a stripe or whether it's a solid, to me, those are my favorite types of polo necks to wear. And yeah, they're like staples in my wardrobe. Polo neck. I've also been into certain pieces of outerwear. Now, I've got 2 favorites at the moment, and I just literally just bung it on and out the door. I'm sharing them with you now what they are. And one of them is this blazer. I already know about this blazer. It is a vintage one that I found, vintage men's. Found it at, where was it? Where did I find this blazer? I'm trying to remember now. Oh yes, no relation. If you look at my vintage shop guide, I'm gonna link it for you right here so you can watch that again. But that is where I scored this from. This is fantastic. And I think I've been reaching for it because it's just so warm, first of all. So it's really functional. It's 100% wool. And it just goes with so much of my aesthetic at the moment. So that is another reason why I've just been drawn to wearing. I'm just kind of looking on the screen here. So you can just, I just love everything about this flipping blazer. It's slightly oversized, but not too much. It fits just the way I would want my favorite blazer to fit. And this has probably become possibly my favorite blazer at the moment, simply from a cost per wear factor. And I've been teaming it with jeans, exactly how you see here now, and I'll just like bung on a pair of like ankle boots with it, and it's just been like an easy out the door piece to wear. Love the length of it as well. To me, this is like the perfect cut for a blazer. It's not too short, it's just the way I'd want it to hit. Obviously, I can't link to this exact same one because it is a vintage one from a men's section, but if I find any good lookalikes, I'd tell you, I will definitely link below. Again, one of the reasons that I kept it from last week's purge was simply because of the warmth factor alone. I mean, especially now it's December, perfect. So another favorite piece that I've been wearing is this coat. Now, I've already talked about this coat, and I don't know if it's available anymore. If it is, I will link it below. Hopefully it's still available, but this coat is, it surprised me. Anyway, I just love the shade of gray for this coat, and I also like that type of print. Like, this check is just so good, and the weight of this coat, I forget, but I think it's either, is it 30 or 80% wool? I know there's a massive difference. I'm gonna have to look back on one of my videos and see if I can put the information for you here. It actually feels like it's more than that, no joke. That's how good the quality is of this coat, plus the weight of it. It's got that fantastic swing that I like, so it just moves really, really well. And it's very, very long. It's got that men's-y finish to it, and oh, I love this thing to pieces. And the best part of it is that you can also trench it. I mean, there's several things about it I like. It's the color of it, it's the cut of it, and also just the fact that you can just trench it like this. I love stuff like that. Wearing it literally over anything and everything. I would obviously wear it exactly how you see right now with a pair of loafers. In fact, I'm wearing loafers with it right now. Let me just show you. She says, kicking her slippers out of the way. I'm just gonna bring this down a bit. Hopefully that is enough. Let me see if you can see. Well, yeah, there you go. See, look what's on my feet. A pair of slippers. Freudian slip, that's how comfortable these are. I'm wearing the Gucci loafers in red. These are the Brixtons, by the way. Anyway, I'm gonna talk about those in a moment. But yeah, this is like a typical way that I've been wearing this kind of coat. It's just with a pair of, like, you know, straight cut jeans and just like a simple jumper, and then I'll bung this over the top of it. And that's just me out the door. Sometimes you just don't want to think, right? You don't want to think, right? It's just too much hard work about what do I wear. You just want to put something on and go. This to me has been that piece, and I absolutely love it. And I would highly recommend anybody who's looking still for a coat to go for something like this. Like, if you've already got your black coat, oh, for goodness sakes, let me turn this off. If you're still looking for a coat and you've already got like a black, because who doesn't have a black coat? Come on. If you don't have a black coat, who are you? Anyway, right? We all have a black coat. Why not get one of these? Grey, checked, but it's like a dark enough grey. It's just, oh, this is just everything. I just know that I'm going to be wearing this next year as well. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. I'm so glad I found this. Another go-to piece for me at the moment. Playing with my hair. Okay, so another favorite that I've really been loving. Notice I'm keeping this coat on. I'm actually keeping it on because I'm going to show you bags. Now, these, I'm just focusing now on the key bags that I've been reaching for the most, like the past 2 to 3 weeks, okay? And it's just been all about Marc Cross for me these past couple of weeks or so. It's actually been way longer than that. Okay, so one of them is this Marc Cross bag. I cannot say anything more about this bag except the fact that I just keep reaching for this bloody thing. This miniaturized suitcase / briefcase looking bag with the gold, hot gold with the black. Oh, God. You already know how I feel about gold with black hardware, and oh God, I so love this little thing. It's just so dinky, and like I said, it's just been something I just reach for because it's just a little black box. I mean, literally, that is all it is, isn't it? It's just a little tiny black box. It comes with a long detachable strap, as you know, quite thin as well, so it's perfect to wear like on my shoulder, and it's adjustable as well. I'll insert some pictures so you can see. So sometimes I wear it on my shoulder, just like on one, or I will cross body it and just wear it like this over like this coat or that blazer or blazers in general. So it's hardly anything that it doesn't go with. Speaking of minimal, another Marc Cross bag has been my favorite at the moment, and it is this Marc Cross Benchley bag. And I like the fact that it's a completely different shape and a completely different color, but it still ticks off the boxes of being structured, which I really am loving at the moment. So this has been a great bag. Color of it is chartreuse. I didn't want to show you in this video because I do want to do a video soon on my new in pieces, because I've got a few, especially after Black Friday, and I was going to lump this in as well, but I'm going to show it to you now because it does apply as well for this video. Yeah, the color of it is like a chartreuse. I can't even speak. It's coming out so bizarre. It's so hard. I'll insert cutaways so you can see the exact color of this bag, but the usual way I wear it is with dark colors, because I find that the secret to a lot of outfits looking sort of, I don't know, just helping you with a guideline is contrast. If I was wearing like a black coat, I would go with this, or if I was wearing any kind of dark coat, navy coat, anything that's darker, I will reach for this because I like the contrast of it against what I'm wearing, and then vice versa. So if I'm wearing something more light, then I will reach for the Marc Cross bag. I love the idea of having both my bases covered with each of these bags. Another favorite that I've been reaching for a lot these past few days. Another go-to at the moment has just been wearing summer dresses, like just loose printed dresses over my jeans. I've hardly worn skirts these past couple of months, actually. I'm not reaching for them that much. But what I am doing instead is replacing that with winterizing my summer dresses. Take this for example. It's a polka dot wrap dress, right? So it's perfect to wear during the summer and the springtime. But I've just been loving just winterizing it like this and just wearing it over like a polo. And I'll just bung this over it and I just layer it over my jeans. I don't know why. I've just had like a shift in the way I'm playing with my clothes. I think that's what it is. So this is just like a good example of that. This is a full length wrap dress. You will see it in a moment. I'll do some cutaways obviously so you can see. It just ties on the side here. And that is it. I've just been rocking these simple dresses just as you see my look right now. And that has been like a go-to look for me. I'm not sure why I'm doing it, like I said, but it's just, it feels very me just layering it in this kind of way. So if this inspires you, definitely rock doing something like this. Just take one of your like long, loose dresses and just try and like layering it. Just see how it's gonna look. Play with it at home and tell me in the comments below if you do, or tag me on Instagram so I can see what you come up with. Another way I've been wearing it is just like this, just completely open. So just open it up and then if you can, then I just wear it just like a, almost like a loose kind of kimono slash cardigan effect. It's kind of just like wearing a top but in a different way, almost like you're wearing like a floor length top. Do you know what I mean? You're really kind of like deconstructing your clothes at that point and just sort of reinventing how you want to wear them in your own way. So that's, I think, kind of a little bit of the psychology that's been going on in my mind at the moment. And I've been doing it the same with this dress as well, which I'll insert a picture of. And I just thought I should share that with you in case that's an idea that you wouldn't mind trying yourself with your clothes. All right, so another favorite. I'm coming down here because I haven't got that new camera yet, the one with the lens that I want changed. Anyway, what was I gonna say to you? These jeans. These have been like my go-to jeans at the moment. And to be honest with you, these are like the gift that keeps on giving. These are H&M jeans. I think I got these like a couple of years ago now, or maybe a year ago, I don't know. But they're called mom jeans. And they always do mom jeans, I've noticed. But anyway, here's a couple that I saw that look exactly like mine. I've linked below for them, but yeah, so they're just straight leg, high-waisted. Like I said, they call them mum jeans. I did this myself. They weren't frayed like this. They were just like normal. So this is, again, one of those go-to pieces that I've just been reaching for all the time. I cannot help myself but put these on. If it's not these, then it's Levi. But yeah, so these are definitely a pair of jeans that I've been wearing on rotation like all the time. And look at me, like crouched down like a little anyway, I'm going to bring this back up. These are the key go-to pieces. This polo neck, these mom jeans, those two pieces, the gray blazer, the long gray wool trench coat, those two things are just, oh, I love those. And I've been reaching for them so much. Those two Mark Cross bags, honestly, like every other day, if you bump into me by accident in Manhattan, that is what you're probably going to see me wearing. One of the items guaranteed that I've just mentioned in this video. I feel like there's something else. I know what it is. Hold on, hold on. Yeah, so these corduroys, I forgot. Flipping corduroy jeans. Corduroy period has like taken over my life. I have been living in these. I absolutely have. You know what I really like about this? It's the bottom part. Look, hold on, look, look. Look how it kick flares out. The fact that it's cropped. Okay, this is such an unflattering angle. Right, so it's this part. That's the way it fits at the bottom. That flare, that right there. Look at the shape at the bottom. Cropped boot cut. If I pull it up a little bit more, it's just absolutely fantastic. I love it. And also, just very lastly, I know these are old and everybody knows about these loafers, but these flipping Gucci loafers, I have been wearing them on flipping rotation. I can't keep talking to you down here. You know what? I should just get down here. Oh, look at this. There you go. You know what? I'm actually going to end the video from here. This is quite funny. So the Gucci loafers are also, I've been wearing a lot in rotation. I just can't help myself. So I think that is it. Is there anything else? No. I'm so comfortable down here. I wish you looked like with me, like just sitting here, right here on the floor. We could just like chat about stuff, have a good little chin wag. But yeah, that is it. I just wanted to show you a video. It's my go-tos. What am I reaching for? What is Karen reaching for at the moment, this past couple of weeks? Actually, tell me in the comments below, what are the pieces that you've been reaching for at the moment? It could be anything. It could be a bag, it could be a pair of shoes, a boot, maybe a scarf that you'll keep reaching for at the moment. But what is it? What is your go-to at the moment, RN? Let me know. And I think that is it. I can't think of anything else. Look at my hair. My hair is growing like a flipping weed. Thought I should set it free for this video. That is it. That is my lot. I hope you lot have a lovely week. I will see you guys on Friday, okay? Take care, my loves. Bye. These are going to be me sharing with you what those are for. That was a really long-winded Oh God, here we go. Press record, Karen can't speak. But in person, and I'm looking at me so I can see what does it really look like. It is not quite as bright, or in person it's not as sheer as it's coming across. Just whether I had the sleeve just scrunched up a little like this, doesn't really matter. However, it doesn't, God, I'm really on a roll today. Doesn't really, I need to work out. So I find that I'm able to be able to like carry a lot of these other things that I might also, okay. Oh God, flipping egg, I can't talk.